Hey, it's another beer review, guys. Today we got, Pearl River, I guess. And then there's, what's that? Zhu Jiang or Jiang beer, however that's pronounced. But brewed and bottled by, I'm not even going to try to pronounce that. But you can see it. Anyway, it's Chinese, and it's the only Chinese beer you can get in our beer store now. They used to have the other one, Sing Tao, or something the other one was, but it they tore it off the shelves. That's the only one they got left. But I guess it's one of the more well-known of the Chinese exported beers. I guess their beer, sort of like craft brews or something like that. They got quite a bunch of varieties over there now, I guess, but this is the only one we can get around here, so, that's a green bottle, so sometimes you don't always get a very good quality, but, it does have a date on it. They say it has a year production, and, best before expired, best before date. It says, let's see, January the 24th, 2012, so it's good for a while yet. Anyway, if the light hasn't messed it up, but they have it on the shelf in the international section of our beer store, and a lot of times if I buy one, I'll get it from the back row so it's not sitting out in the light as much, so I've had better luck that way. But anyway, I'll open her up here. So I can smell it now. Hope that'll go away. Alright, so it's pretty generic, I guess, sort of adjunct lager, I believe, is what it is. Probably rice-based, I would imagine. But, a little bit of head there. Got a nice Pump House Brewery glass. I'm going to give her a smell. I'm getting a little bit of skunky, but I think that's... A lot of these, you open them, and there's a little bit of sort of skunk, and then it sort of goes away. So, hopefully this will go away. Yeah, there it goes. Yeah, it gets sort of grassy, grainy, there's a touch of skunk left, I guess. It's sort of going away now, but that's one that was sitting out in front. Sort of a light malty kind of smell, but it's mostly sort of a grassy, sort of sweet smell. Maybe just a tiny little bit of hops, but not really too much. And I should mention this is, 5.3% alcohol, so it's a little bit higher than average. But yeah, it smells better now. Yeah, grainy, grassy. So sort of smells like some of the European lagers, I guess. Just there's not much hops or anything going on. I'm gonna give her a taste. Yeah, it's sort of a quite sweet, a little bit of breadiness, dryness at the end. Very smooth. There's no real carbonation bite or anything. No hop bite. Yeah, it's very drinkable, very smooth. It's a bit too sweet in some ways, but it almost tastes kind of like, not honey sweetness, but it sort of has a sweetness to it. It's where, like, some of the cheaper domestic lagers have kind of a little bit sweet. But it's not bad. It's not offensive. There's nothing. This was in the cooler or in the fridge for a whole day, so it's well chilled. As you can see, it's sweating pretty good there. But it's not bad. I don't mind it once in a while. I'm not gonna say it's the best beer in the world, but it's not. You know, nothing bad about it. There's a lot more taste than some, so, you know, for as Chinese beers go, I guess. Not that I've had too many of them, but, I remember, I think Tsingtao kind of reminded me of Heineken or something, but it's been a long time since I've had that, but, anyway, I give this one a thumbs up. Anyway, it's, not bad. It's not super, but it's not, you know, quite drinkable on a hot day. It gives you a little extra alcohol, so, you know, a little more bang for the buck, I guess. So, anyway, thanks for watching, and talk to you guys later.